Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how Photoshop's 8 special blending modes work. These special blending modes are a bit different than the rest, and what I'm going to do in this video is show you what the differences are and how you can take advantage of them. If you want to know more about blending modes and how they all work, then don't forget to watch my tutorial on blending modes. I go through each individual blend mode and explain how it works. By the way, if you're new to the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button for more free tutorials. Okay, let's get started. So we're gonna talk about the 8 special blend modes, and these are it here, the ones highlighted in yellow. This is just simply a screenshot of the dropdown of all the blend modes, and the blend modes highlighted in yellow react differently when you adjust the fill and opacity, and also when you uncheck a special box in the layer style panel. And we're gonna go through that in a moment. I just wanna make sure that you understand that this video only applies to color burn, linear burn, color dodge, linear dodge add, vivid light, linear light, hard mix, and difference. So in this group, I have this graphic. I'm gonna disable it now. And we're gonna be working with this image here. The image is really not that important. I just needed an image to show you how the different blend modes work. So you can follow along with any image. So I'm gonna create a new layer right above that layer of the young man, and I'm gonna fill that with 50% gray. So I'm gonna hold shift and backspace. And that's gonna bring up the fill window. You can also go into edit and fill if you don't wanna use the keyboard shortcut. And under content, select 50% gray. And press OK. This is going to fill the layer with 50% gray, and we can change the blend mode to hard mix. Now, you probably have seen this blend mode before, but you probably never found it very useful. If I bring down the opacity, you'll see that it still doesn't look very good and there's not a lot of uses for it. But if we adjust the fill, notice the difference. And if we leave the fill roughly at 20%, you'll see that now we can use it for something. We can use it to add contrast and to saturate the image a little bit. So that's before and that's after. So a lot of these 8 blend modes, you might have not seen a use for them because you probably have only been using the opacity slider, not the fill. So with these 8 blend modes, those two react differently. Also, if you're painting directly on a layer, I'm gonna click on the brush tool and I'm gonna change the blend mode to linear dodge add, you get this result when you paint with white. But if I create a new layer and paint with white, you don't get that result. Notice the difference. See how this brush stroke on top seems hotter and brighter on the edges, and this one does not, even though we're in the same blend mode. And if we switch the blend mode on the layer to the linear dodge add blending mode, it still doesn't change. And that is because you need an extra step. So if you double click on the side of the layer and uncheck transparency, shapes, layers, notice what happens to this brushstroke here. It now seems hot and bright like the one above it. So if you paint with one of these 8 blend modes directly on a layer, you're gonna get different results than if you paint on a separate layer. And if you want that separate layer to have the same results as painting directly on the layer, you need to double click on the side of the layer and uncheck transparency shapes layers. So I'm just gonna cancel that. And I'm actually gonna undo to remove that brushstroke from the actual layer. So what I recommend you do is go through those 8 blend modes and paint with either white, 50% gray, or black, and see how the image reacts by adjusting the fill and opacity and also uncheck that box, just so you can get different results. And one of the things that you can do using these techniques is something you have probably seen me do before if you follow my tutorials. So you can create sun flares and highlights, or lights, specular highlights and things like that. So what I'm gonna do in this tutorial is show you how to turn this piece of white that you see back here, I'm not really sure what that is, it looks like it's just the board, how to turn that into a light. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a new layer. So I'm gonna tap in the center of the image just with a small soft brush. Make sure that white is your foreground color. And there it is. I'm going to press Control T, Command T to transform and scale that up by holding Shift Alt Shift Option on the Mac and bring that up right about there. I'm going to press V on the keyboard to select the move tool, click and drag so we can move this around. Then I'm going to double click on the side of the layer here and go into the blending mode and choose Linear Dodge Add and uncheck Transparency, Shapes, Layers to get that different blend and press OK. So now this looks like a highlight. I can put that right over here and notice how this is looking like a bright light, which is what I want. I can bring down the fill. So now it looks like the light is not as bright. And actually, I'm going to bring the fill back up and I'm going to bring down the opacity just so you can see the difference. See how if I bring the opacity down, it looks flat. I'm at 58% now. I'm going to go down further to 38%. So notice the difference if I bring down the fill. And I'm going to go to 38% as well. There you go, 37%. It doesn't look as flat as it did before. But anyway, so we'll leave it at 100% for now and then we'll reduce it if we need to. What I'm going to do now is add some color to this light. So I'm going to create a new Hue and Saturation Adjustment layer, click on Colorize, and then we're gonna clip this to the layer below it so that it only affects the highlight. So you can press Ctrl-Alt-G, Command-Option-G on the Mac to turn that into a clipping mask. Notice this down-pointing arrow here right next to the adjustment layer. You could also click on this icon here in the Properties panel to do the same thing. And what I'm gonna do now is make sure that I have Colorize checked. Then I'm going to click and drag the lightness slider to the left so we can get some of that color going in there. Notice how this is looking red now. I can adjust the hue slider, move that to the right, maybe get it to the blues. Now we have a blue light and that's what I want. I'm going to now click on this layer here, which is the light, and I'm just going to rename it and call it light. Light, and just bring down the fill accordingly. So now this looks like light. So that's before and after. And of course, I will need to do other things to the image to make this light a little more realistic. But in this tutorial, I just wanted to focus on the technique of creating the light. So once again, these are the 8 blend modes that react differently with fill and opacity, and the 8 blend modes that will blend differently if you unchecked transparency shapes layer. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, feel free to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often do a search for this hashtag to see what you're all up to. If I find your image, I will leave you a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on that like button. If you have a friend who you think will enjoy this tutorial, please share this link with them now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.